It's been pretty cold here in Germany this week, and I asked myself how our 3D prints can handle these low temperatures. This is why I tested PLA, ABS, PETG, nylon, and polycarbonate for their performance at freezing temperatures. Guten Tag everybody, I'm Stefan, and welcome to CNC Kitchen. We probably all know how our 3D prints handle high temperatures and that PLA is not good over 50 degrees Celsius, and with ABS, nylon or polycarbonate you can probably go up to 100 degrees Celsius, but I didn't find a lot about low temperature performance of these materials. At least for our standard, it has been pretty cold this week, so I thought this would make a perfect topic for a new video. For this reason, I printed test samples in the most common 3D printing materials, tested them at ambient temperatures for our baseline, and then cooled them down to minus 20 degrees Celsius and performed the same tests again. The results were pretty interesting. I didn't perform the whole range of tests I usually do for my filament test series, because this would have been way too much work for the 5 different materials at 2 temperatures. Therefore, I selected my trusty test hook to assess the static strength of the material and the notched ISO test specimens for the impact strength. This will give us an idea how the ductility of the 3D prints change and if they get more brittle. We'll also get a pretty interesting overview about the general strength of the different materials when we compare them side by side. I have to say that your mileage will vary depending on the brand of material you use, because even though your material is, for example, also PLA based, doesn't mean that the performance will be the same. Additives the manufacturers use for better printability and adjusting properties might change the general material behavior and also the one at lower temperatures. The same is applicable for the other materials in the test. I used Form Futura, Premium PLA, Das Filament, PETG, 3DK Berlin ABS, Form Futura STYX12, which is a PA12, and Polymaker's PC Max for my test samples. The hooks were printed at 0.165mm layer height, 3 perimeters, 8 top and bottom layers, and 30% cubic infill. The impact specimens were printed with 4 perimeters at 0.15mm layer height and 100% infill, all on my trusty old Prusa i3 Mark IIs. The baseline tests were performed at around 20 degrees Celsius ambient temperature. The PLA hook was the strongest, breaking at 84 kg, followed by the PC Max hook at 82 kg. The PETG and nylon hook failed around 70 kg, where it was interesting to see that they didn't fail abruptly, but strained quite a lot during failure. The ABS hook was the weakest, failing at 59 kg. Since I know that the impact test results usually scatter a lot, I tested 3 samples for each material, where, not surprisingly, the polycarbonate part was the strongest, absorbing on average 71% of the energy of the 2-joule impact hammer. The PA12 samples absorbed 36% and ABS 30%. The DAS filament PETG showed much better impact strength than I was expecting and absorbed 21% of the energy. PLA, as expected, doesn't have a great impact strength and was only able to absorb 6% of the hammer's energy. Now we come to the interesting part, the low temperature performance. By the way, if you liked the video, then don't forget to give it a like, share it, and if you really want to support my research, consider becoming a Patreon. I was facing the problem of how to cool my samples down properly. I didn't want to go for liquid nitrogen because this would have been an unrealistically low temperature. Also, my freezer is too far away from my office that I could take all the samples from there. So I decided to go with a cooling bath, in which I stored my samples in a plastic bag that they don't get wet. I used around 1 kg of ice cubes that I partly crushed. Then I added around 0.5 kg of sodium chloride. Always remember to wear proper safety equipment if you are working with these dangerous chemicals. I have heard that sodium chloride may lead to severe hypertension, and you don't want to have that. After you have mixed up everything, you'll have a cooling bath that will stay around minus 20 degrees Celsius for quite a while, so perfect for cooling down my samples for the test. I know that minus 20 degrees Celsius is not the lowest temperature you might encounter where you are living, but this was the simplest setup I could come up with and that still will show a difference in material performance. I kept the samples in the bath for quite a while until I was sure that they were completely cooled down and then started the impact test. I touched the samples with a double layer of gloves to introduce as little as possible heat and performed the tests as fast as possible. Polymaker's PC Max suffered quite a bit in these low temperatures and was only able to absorb half of the energy as at ambient. Nylon also dropped from 36 to 25% during the impact tests, whereas the performance of ABS didn't suffer too much. PETG was still performing way better than I expected, also showed a little bit less strength. The performance of PLA didn't really change a lot, still being quite low, but this might just be due to the resolution of my test setup. The result of the hook tests surprised me quite a bit in the beginning because all the hooks were able to bear more load at minus 20 degrees Celsius than at ambient temperature. It took over 100 kilograms to get the PLA hook to fail. Polycarbonate improved from 82 to 91 kilograms. PETG from 71 to 85 kilograms, nylon from 79 to 83 kilograms, and also ABS improved by almost 20% to over 80 kilograms of failure load. This sounds a little counterintuitive at first, but makes sense if you know that ductility and strength usually changes in opposite directions. If a material becomes less ductile, so more brittle, the strength usually increases. Let's take a look at the PETG sample that strained a lot at ambient temperature, but shattered at low temperatures. The test graph shows that straining started way later, but shortly after it started, the part failed abruptly. This was more or less the same for all of the other materials. So what does that mean in real life? Well, ductility is a very positive property of a material because it makes it more robust. This means that ductile materials will start to strain during overload, therefore shift and distribute the applied loads more evenly over the part and therefore may bend a little, but not fail catastrophically that fast. Brittle materials might be able to bear more load, but if they get slightly overloaded, fail on short notice. Though I think this test has shown that none of the materials completely changed its behavior at minus 20 degrees Celsius. So, even though you might not be able to expect the full performance of your part, it probably remains quite usable. The lower the temperatures will get, the more brittle and maybe unusable some materials will become. So, I'd be really interested to know how your experience with 3D prints during the winter or maybe only in your freezer is. Have you had parts badly failing in the minus 40 degrees Celsius Canadian winter? Please leave a comment down below. I guess I was able to show you how the properties of your 3D printed parts change at lower temperatures. If you enjoyed the video and learned something, then please leave a like and subscribe to my channel. Consider becoming a Patreon to support my work and take a look at the other interesting videos on my channel. Thanks for watching, auf Wiedersehen, and I'll see you next time.